I dripped gallium metal onto the aluminum heatsink. I carefully applied it evenly, but nothing happened. So I add a bit of potassium permanganate. But this metal was still nothing happened. I wait for a while. This is different from what I thought, but I would never doubt the purity of hydrogen peroxide. It's too beautiful in slow-mo. I will try this violently chemical reaction again, but ... must be safe. Mixing them with tweezers is also a good idea. Then I will try to add sodium borohydride to hydrogen peroxide. Also a big explosion. I hope you can try to explain why the red flame is appearing in comments. Hydrogen peroxide has strong hydrogen bonds, so it has a lot of surface tension. This is 30% hydrogen peroxide. You can easily buy it. Nothing happened because it contains too much water. Then I try 98% hydrogen peroxide. Of course, sodium borohydride is also indispensable. Because of sodium borohydride contains hydrogen in a negative valence state, so it is extremely reducible. I will try to use more different oxidants in next video. The explosion is unbelievable. A few milligrams of sodium borohydride is enough to destroy a cotton pad. This made my ears ring for a while. Unlike other explosives, these two chemicals can explode violently when they come into contact. Iodine slowly reacts with hydrogen peroxide and produces some iodic acid. Hydrogen peroxide is decomposed by vibration, creating some bubbles. But if I add a bit of lead wire, it will have different phenomena. Lead can help hydrogen peroxide to decompose. And heating this solution. Some iodine vapors appeared in the test tube. But in the end, water vapor pushes iodine vapor out of the test tube. This piece of ammonium carbonate is too large, so it can't slide into the tube by itself. It produces some nitrogen and carbon dioxide gas. This reaction can occur spontaneously. Thank you for watching, and welcome to write your suggestions in the comment area.